now clawing its way into the beautiful Florida skies. The Helio can be up and gone in as short as 150 feet. Although the airstrips that we normally operate from overseas are about 700 to 1,500 feet in length, they are made out of dirt, sand, grass, gravel, rock, mud, or any combination of the above. They are frequently sloped. They have been hacked out of jungles and scraped off the sides of mountains. But it is in these places where the remote and marginalized people of the world live, who have no access to medical care, education, or more importantly, the transforming power of the Word of God. Mike is coming around now for a short field landing. He will do a three-point landing, slow approach speed, slow touchdown speed, and he can get down and stop in as little as 100 feet. And he's down, but he's not going to be down for long. He's going to do a stop and go, and he is now going to do another short field takeoff into a maneuver we call the Canyon Climb. Imagine, if you will, ladies and gentlemen, that we are deep in a river valley with rock walls on both sides. And the only way to safely climb out of this deep valley is to climb directly over the airstrip. You might be wondering, what kinds of things do we carry in missionary airplanes? Well, you name it. Kettles and kids, pigs and pipes, bags, baskets, boxes, doctors, dentists, metal, medicine and mail, anything and everything that missionaries need to live and work in the remote corners of the world. As Mike climbs to altitude, he's going to break out of the canyon climb, and he is going to pour on the coals, crank up the flaps. As soon as he reaches 500 feet above ground level, he'll begin cranking up the flaps. This is remarkable performance for an airplane that carries 1,000 pounds of passengers and cargo. Six passengers, 295 horsepower. Mike is done with the canyon climb now, and he is going to be coming around for a cruise pass. Now, the Helio is not a particularly fast airplane, but I can tell you from personal experience, it is a whole lot faster than a dugout canoe. Speed is important, and when you have a medical patient on board, speed literally means life. Mike is going to be doing a teardrop turn out there to the left, and he is going to set up for the slow pass. Let me take you back to Tulsa, Oklahoma in the spring of 1955, when the founder of JARS and Wycliffe Bible Translators, Cameron Townsend, had been praying for an airplane that could fly fast enough to cover the large distances found in South America, yet one that could fly slow enough to land on the wet, muddy jungle airstrips where his Bible translators worked in Peru. And as he looked up, he saw a sight that you are seeing at this very moment. An airplane moving very slowly in the sky, and he knew that the answer to his prayers was before him. And that began a long association with JARS and the Helio Courier, the messenger of light, taking the truth of God's word to the remote corners of the world. Mike has just done a canyon turn and will now be lining up for the wing-rocking pass. He will bank the wings 45 degrees left and right, allowing the interceptors to pop up and to allow full control at low and slow airspeeds. Missionary pilots operate in a very challenging aeronautical environment, and they frequently find themselves in the mountains, high density altitudes, and having to maneuver in a very low and slow place, but yet having to do so very safely. The Helio has been an excellent tool for doing this for more than 50 years. Another teardrop turn out there to the right. Mike will now do the slats pass, where he will pitch the aircraft up and down. And as he does so, there are four slats on the leading edges of the wings, and they're not controlled by the cockpit. They're actually controlled aerodynamically. And so as he passes your location, take a look at the leading edges of those wings, and you'll see the slats extend and retract. Extend and retract. Another one of the high lift devices built into the Helio Courier that make it a fantastic tool to operate in the difficult places around the world. In addition to the Helio Courier, at JARS we also fly a number of other aircraft, including the Pilatus PC-6 Porter, the pickup truck with wings, the Pilatus PC-12 for going high and fast and doing medical evacuation work. We also have three of the brand new Quest Kodiak aircraft. Our friends at Quest are here, and that airplane is a tough airplane built for backcountry flying, very, very much like what we do in the missionary world all overseas. We also fly the Bell Long Ranger helicopter and the Robinson R-44. All right. Mike is coming to the left now, and he is going to set up for the hover pass. Now, obviously, only helicopters can hover, but the Helio Courier is designed and built to fly very, very slowly, low airspeeds, low altitude, under full and safe control. So let's see just how slow Mike can make it go. The Helio can maintain straight and level flight at 30 knots, 30 knots. Remarkable for an airplane that carries 6 passengers, 1,000 pounds of passengers and cargo. If you're interested in missions or mission aviation, I have good news for you. All skill sets are needed in missions. Not only are we looking for pilots and mechanics, but we also need teachers, computer specialists, communication specialists, and all sorts of folks, managers, administrators, all skill sets are needed in missions. Mike is running downwind now, and as he does so, I'd like to invite you to come visit us at JARS over at the Fly for Life tent over in the Southeast Exhibit area. We have 4 mission aviation organizations in the Fly for Life tent, including JARS, New Tribes Aviation, Liberty University, and Mission Aviation Fellowship. We're in the Southeast Exhibit area, just over the bridge at the Fly for Life tent. Mike is setting up now for another short field landing. He's going to land on the grass airstrip this time, from which mission pilots are much more familiar. He's picked out a point down the airstrip and will attempt to put the airplane down on all 3 wheels simultaneously. Precision is the hallmark of the mission aviation pilot. And he is down. And now, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of JARS, thank you very much.